Hi guys and girls, it's Eduardo here in the salubrious surroundings of the Sefton, and I'm sitting in the garden. I've got a lovely pint of Carling. Cheers, my dears. And you know what? Have a quick sip.
Excuse me.
It's fabulous to be out on a sunny Wednesday afternoon. First time I've been out for a while, and I'm loving it. Anyway. A lot of people have been asking me how this actually happened. This is basically a quick video to show you how well I'm doing. If you're like, here's my leg, red for Liverpool. So anyway, I've been doing really good. So how it happened, my mate Eddie McCormack and I were doing a film in Newsham Park, and the basis of the premise of the film was Eddie, in his wisdom, said, you have to jump out of that tree. This is the tree by the kiosk. Now, if anyone who ever has been past that part of the park, they'll know that it's a pretty high tree. Anyway, we all turned up in fancy dress, and I said beforehand to Ed, I'm already in this film, because this is part of a bigger film about the Beatles, which is under wraps at the moment, but you will find out in the fullness of time. So this was sort of like, if you like, an addendum to that film, where we were trying to recreate Strawberry Fields Forever video. We ever seen the Beatles doing that, the Fab Four? Great video. So Eddie insisted that we have to jump out of this tree, sitting on our bums, then we jump, and then we land on our feet, and don't fall, and we walk nonchalantly past the camera, like John Lennon, Paul McCartney, George, or Ringo would have done. Unfortunately, it wasn't happening. There was a load of brown grass at the bottom of the tree, which anyone knows, horticultural experts amongst you, will know, very slippery. So it turns out, four of us jumped, and four of us fell. I, at this stage, thought, I'll get in as well, big time Charlie here, trying to impress the girls who were present. So I jumped on, landed on my bum, couldn't stop laughing, fine. So we quickly realised this isn't happening, this is too dangerous, apart from big time Charlie here, who had a second go. So gets up, jumps, and the funny thing is, just seconds before I jumped, it was almost like a mist came over me. I'm not messing. It was like a premonition, Eddie, something's gonna happen here. Lo and behold, I jumped and I went, pow, landed on my feet, square, didn't twist anything, but I knew something was seriously wrong, and it turns out it was my leg and my ligaments, and I broke my leg. Everyone was laughing, including me. I got up and it's all done. Anyway, to cut a long story short, we still had to film a scene in the children's playground there at Newsham Park. So I carried on for half an hour, just limping on it, thinking, oh, it'll get better. And the original plan was, right, let's get this last scene done, which involved going round on a roundabout. You can imagine a psychedelic sort of vibe. Anyway, that got done, and in the end, I had to tell everyone, guys, this is like worse or more serious than I thought it was, because my original plan was going to go home, watch the second half of the Holland Costa Rica game in the World Cup, put some ice on it. Wasn't happening. So Eddie and another friend of mine, Kimberly, they escorted me by taxi to the Royal. I got there about 9:15 on that nice Saturday night, and I left about just after 12, which is good for a Saturday night in the Royal. Anyway, turns out I broke my leg, and now here I am now. Now, an awful lot of people also, in terms of, I'm going on about this leg again, and I'm sorry to be a bore, guys, but what I'm saying is, a lot of people have been asking, can we see footage of when you actually broke your leg? Because Eddie, being the ultimate professional, he filmed that as well. So, if you're of a nervous disposition, viewer sort of sensibilities are going to be challenged here. So, as I say, if you're of a nervous disposition, look away now, because you're going to show how I broke my leg.
Yeah, you ready?
Okay.
Was that a snap then?
Oh, I hope not.
Anyway, the good news is I went to the Royal again last week with the appointment, and you know what the nurse said to me? She said, Edward, I had to call you real name in those situations, don't they? Edward, brilliant news. I said, what's happening? And she said, turn up in 4 weeks' time with your other trainee and a little bit of support on your ankle, and you can walk away, Rene. And I'm like, yeah. And the funny thing is, the day before, last Tuesday, a friend of mine called Jan Ord, who I originally met at an NLP meeting a few years ago in St. Francis of Assisi in Mission Park, and she came along and gave me acupuncture, which involved putting 5 needles in each ear. Yeah? Take this glass off, haven't they? 5 needles in each ear, and they correspond with different parts of your body. For example, she put one in for my heart, and that didn't hurt, was it a bit? That's another story. She put one in for my lungs, cool in the gang, didn't hurt. She put one in for my kidneys, and I went, ow! And she said, did you have a drink last night? I said, yeah, I had a couple of lagers. She said, that's why. So it's interesting that your ear can correspond with a different part of your body when you do the acupuncture. That helps. And she also said, Jan, she said, visualize it. You remember that lesson I told you? Visualize being a 7-year-old and you're healing your leg. So there's been lots of visualization going on. No one's sitting in me flat, you know, on my own. And that's been great, because I knew I was going to get good news in the hospital last Wednesday, because I've been being really positive. Okay, there's been times when I've been like prisoner cell block H. I felt like I was Papillon stuck in, no cabin fever, especially when the Giants came, because all my friends, Eddie, Kimberly, Karen, Debbie, lots of others, are all having picnics and bottles of wine and food in the park, and I wanted to be there, but quickly realised I could make it to the park just, but there was thousands of people there, so I didn't go. So anyway, that was the only time I felt a bit down about it, because as I say, I've been really positive, and so things are looking good, guys. So just as I say, prognosis report in about, what, well, that was last Wednesday when the Aussie, so in about 3 weeks and 1 day from now, maybe, yeah, is that right? Or yeah. I should be able to get the plaster off, and I think I've broken all Commonwealth, Olympic and world records on getting this plaster off, because I'm a positive person and I've shown on this, and it's great. And in terms of today, Eddie's kindly said, Ed, I'm off work for a week, we're gonna give you a day out. So we've just been to an important business meeting with about filming later in the year, which is hush hush, tell you another time. And now I find myself in the, as I say, the salubrious surroundings of downtown West Derby Village. There's a Tesco's over there, which I'm gonna do a bit of shopping for later. There's William Hill, which I won't go near, I don't fancy having a bed. But yeah, so I'm gonna get some goodies from Tesco later. Gonna have a couple of beers. Maybe even treat myself to something to eat. So I'm gonna have the try the risotto. It's nice in here, but no, seriously, I'm gonna have maybe a bit of steak and chips and veg and stuff like that. Just to well, treat it. You know. So it's good to be out. And anyway, guys, I've bored you enough. That's the latest update, and fingers crossed. Might do one more before the plaster comes off. Might not, see how I feel. But hopefully next time you see me, I'll be running down tube route to the flat house or whatever, and. I'll be back to normal. I'll be fixed again. So, thank you for listening, guys. Speak to you soon. Bye-bye.